secret mobile device management tool that feels illegal to know. It's AirDroid device management tool. This is how the dashboard looks like, where it contains the options to enroll your company mobile or Windows laptop devices. Click on that and this will open the device enrollment page. We have two options. One is to download the Android APK file and to scan the QR code on the right side of the screen or enter the deployment code. Method 2 is entering the URL shown on the screen in your mobile web browser to download the software. In the phone, it opens a BizDemon app. You would need to click on the install button. You would receive this prompt that the app is blocked to protect your device since has sensitive information. This is because Google Play Store Play Protect does not allow this app to be installed. To remove the protection, click on the Google Play Store and click on profile icon. And click on Play Protect. Click on the settings in the top right corner. Now turn off these two options. Click on turn off. Find the APK file again and click on it. Now click on install again to install the application. Click on open. Click on continue. Choose a name for this mobile device and click on continue. You would need to enable the various permissions on this screen. Click on accessibility. Click on settings. Click on OK. Now you can see that BizDemon would be disabled. And if you click on it, it shows restricted settings. Click on OK. To enable this, you would need to go to settings. Click the app settings. Click on app management. Find the BizDemon application. Click on the three dotted lines at the top and click on allow restricted settings. Now open the BizDemon application again, click on the accessibility, and click on OK. Now, BizDemon has been enabled. Click on it and turn on the BizDemon button. Click on Allow. Allow permission access for location, phone, contacts, call logs, storage, camera, microphone, device admin app. While turning on device admin apps, there will be a prompt to enter the CAPTCHA. Enter it and click on Activate. Click on Activate in the next prompt. Turn on other permissions such as usage access, installation of unknown apps, app notifications, display over other apps, changing of system settings, and ignore battery optimization. Click on Complete. Now all the permissions have been enabled. In the desktop client version, click on All Devices button on the left side. You can see that my device has been added. Clicking on the device provides detailed information of the device from battery capacity, brightness, storage, etc. Click on Remote Operation. This opens us a prompt to perform three remote actions. 1. Remote Camera Access. Clicking on it allows the desktop client to open the phone camera remotely and take screenshots if required. 2. View Mode. Clicking on it allows the desktop client users to view the phone without rooting the device. There is an option to take screenshots. You can also change the orientation of the device as well by clicking on this icon. But you will not able to change or control the device. You can view and take screenshots only. 3. Click on Remote Control Feature. This feature allows you to remotely control the device and make changes to the device remotely for easy troubleshooting. It also has a black screen feature which allows it to show that the device is in maintenance mode, allowing the IT administrator or developer to make the necessary company policy changes in the device, protecting the confidentiality of the company policies. Click on Workbench. This function allows to creation of workflows for sending out notification alerts or changing the status of the device from online to offline or battery low reminders. Under the Tasks and Action Logs function, we can set up tasks to be completed, such as clearing app data and cache data in the mobile app or rebooting a device, which would are repeated tasks to be conducted frequently. The task can be set up for specific devices or groups of devices as well. Click on the Apps button. Click on Overview. AirDroid has the following application management services which allow users to create or update apps, perform staged rollouts by country or device groups, apps being released based on demand for specific users who would need certain apps to be installed in their Windows device or handheld devices. Force installation for serious errors on existing apps so that it can be resolved quickly. Scheduled release allows to schedule the release of the application. We can also customize the name, icon, and image according to the branding requirements. Under the app library, it helps to show a list of approved applications to be released to the enrolled devices. To send an app to your device, click on the Add App button. Choose the type of the app as Android or Windows and click on Next. Simply drag and drop the APK file and AirDroid will upload the application. Click on Next. You can customize the necessary information such as app name and description. You can customize the logo as well. Click on Next. You can publish the app for test release for certain devices by clicking on the Add button and choosing the target device. This is the test release screen where you can roll out the app by clicking on Formal Release button. Next is the release page where it has the option to release the app to devices enrolled by clicking on the Release button. Now the app is released. In the mobile, if I click on the app library icon, I can find the released application which can be installed on the device and used. The app gets added in the organization app library. Under the policy and kiosk section, there are options to set up configuration or rules that the enrolled devices needs to perform. Some ready-to-use templates are available for easy deployment. For the kiosk section, we can configure the necessary functions as well, such as allowed apps, etc. Company policies, such as password policies, allowed apps to be installed in the devices, and blocked apps can be configured as well. Specific functions of the phone can be restricted as well, such as disabling camera, screenshot, microphone, USB file transfer, USB external device connection disabling, adding or removing Google accounts, incoming and outgoing call functions, etc. Under the brand layout, we can customize how the home screen layout looks like for the kiosk mode. Under the geofencing part, the real-time location of the mobile device can be captured in a map with the historical tracking of the movement of the people using the device as well by click on the path tracking feature. By clicking on the device and clicking on app list, we can monitor what apps has been installed in the company device for governance purposes. Under the remote support section, we can remotely control unattended devices for troubleshooting, can perform screen sharing, pinpoint issues by using the AR camera feature for guiding customer on the site while working with real-world objects as if you were on site. If you click on the devices and click on the device and click on action button, you will have many options to choose from rebooting the device, clearing app and cache data, factory reset, etc. To unroll the device, simply click on unenroll device. You would be prompted to enter the password and the device will be unenrolled. To remove an app, simply click on the apps and click the delete button to remove the app from the app library. AirDroid Business is your go-to solution for effective mobile device management. With its powerful features, you can streamline your IT resources, reduce costs, and increase efficiency across your organization. They are currently offering a 14-day free trial. Click the link in the bio to access it. Follow Computer Geeks for more tips and tricks.